This is Mission Control Houston. Welcome today to the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where the team of experts is watching over the systems for the International Space Station. As the crew aboard the station, Expedition 31 Commander Oleg Kononenko and his fellow Russians Gennady Padalka and Sergey Revin, along with NASA astronauts Don Pettit and Joe Acaba, and European Space Agency astronaut Andrei Kuipers are midway through their day, a very busy day today of preparations for the departure of the Dragon commercial spacecraft from the Earth-facing port of the Harmony Mode tomorrow. The crew has been working to close out hatches that occurred about 2 hours ago. And we're getting some live downlink television as Don Pettit prepares to put the center cover over the hatchway. They've just completed the installation of the controller panel assemblies. You can see those four square boxes around the edges of the hatchway. Those are used to control the 16 bolts that drive in to provide a snug fit between visiting spacecraft and the space station's hatches. And all that installation went very well, and now he's doing the final installations of the hatch cover. They're going to leave one power cable connected overnight and then do some final checkouts of the bolts and latches tomorrow before we do the unberthing. Those activities are nominal for the release. Of course, the crew also doing a lot of science work on the space station today, working with several different Russian experiments, looking at the Earth below and how materials behave in space. They also are working with the viable experiment. That's something that is being done by Andrei Kuipers. That's a name for the process of relaxation in the ultraband spectrum by high velocity interaction of exhaust products, and that's the RelaxGaia experiment, one of the ones that the Russian experiments are working on. They're also going to be working on, as mentioned, the viable experiment. That viable experiment stands for the evaluation and monitoring of microbiofilms inside the International Space Station. And it essentially looks at how microbes, films, develop on general surfaces, both metallic and fabric inside the space station, so that they can look for good ways to protect against runaway growth of any of those. Overall, a very good day for the International Space Station crew. They'll be knocking off work and trying to shift their schedule 2 hours earlier to get ready for tomorrow's departure activities for Dragon. The release of the Dragon spacecraft from the robotic arm is scheduled for 4:35 a.m. Central Time. There will be no need for the use of the LIDARs or thermal imagers as it departs, but there may be some testing as they depart as the opportunity rises. We'll have Dragon departure coverage starting at 1:30 a.m. Central Time. Unberthing is scheduled for 3:05 a.m. Central Time, and then the release of Dragon is scheduled for 4:35 a.m. Central Time. There are going to be several deorbit departure and deorbit burns that will be following up on the Dragon departure, those all will be taking place sometime in the early morning time frame for us here in Houston. But all systems go on the International Space Station as the crew is getting ready to see the departure of the first commercial spaceflight to the International Space Station. The station visiting vehicle Dragon is packed full of return items, experiment samples, and items that are going to be refurbished for future use on board the space station. And the crew is well in hand with the procedures to get ready for that departure tomorrow.